Hi, and welcome to the SoCal Yearbook Gal education series designed to inspire, encourage, support, and make your life easier. This week, we're talking about budget worksheets and why it's so important to keep an eye on your budget and to have help keeping an eye on your budget. So, especially this year, you're going to want to make that book something special and really, really cool. You're going to want to give parents an additional reason to purchase your book. You want to maybe make your cover look super snazzy. And a lot of these things cost money. And so it's important for you to keep an accurate budget worksheet and focus on how much money you're bringing in book sales and ad sales, and then how much money you're going to be spending. And so the best thing you can do is make sure that you know the dollar amount of your contract, make sure that you know how many ads you're planning on selling and how much that is going to bring in, and make sure that you are bringing in that money from your book sales as well. And then also be sure that you keep a really close eye on what you do to your book. If you're going to do upgraded paper, or if you're going to print on your end sheets, or if you're going to do something crazy. I have a number of schools who want to do die cuts in their covers so that you have like a little window into the front end sheet. Really cool stuff. Just remember that all of that costs money. And so if you're going to be either selling more ads, or if you have donors, or if you're reaching out to your alumni association to help you out, these are all great ways of increasing your budget so that you can actually do cool stuff with your cover. If you reduce your number of pages, that can also increase your budget a little bit, but remember that that comes at a cost with your coverage. If you reduce your number of copies, it can actually do the opposite of what you're wanting to do with your budget. So what that can do is, as the number of copies reduces, the cost, yes, the total contract amount will also go down. However, your cost per copy will increase. And so just keep that in mind. If you're used to having a book cost you $90, just keep in mind that if you reduce your number of copies, that book, the copy price might go up to $91 or $92 per book. And so that can kind of offset your budget. So keep that in mind when you're deciding on all those cool, fancy things that you're going to do with your book. Think about ways to increase your budget that, for example, increasing your copies by selling more books. You can reach out, as I said, to the Alumni Association to see if they're interested in putting money toward your total contract amount so that you can reduce the cost per copy so that you could do some really cool things to your book. There's a lot of different ways of reaching out and getting a little bit of help. Increasing your ads also helps. Just make sure that you price those ads carefully. And that really, there's a little bit of math involved there where you need to make sure that you know how much you're paying per page. And then I would definitely at least double the price that you're paying per page in your ads. So for example, if your publishing company is charging you $100 a page, make sure that you're making at least $200 per page on a full page ad. And then if you were to say fill it up with eighth page ads, then probably you'll be at about $400 a page because of the way that your pricing structure is. So keep that in mind. If you have any questions about how to price ads, please do reach out to me. I have seen people in the past actually lose money on their ads. And so they're selling ads, but then it's not covering their cost per page. So be really, really careful with that. And again, if you need any help with that, please feel free to reach out to me.